So in the past I've shown you in Numbers how to use the lookup functions to look up a number in a row or a column based on another row or column. But what if the data is two-dimensional? Like for instance here we have a table that has prices and we have stores going across, and these are store names, and then products going down. These are product names. And you want to be able to look up a specific cell based on a store and a product. So for instance if you want to find the price of an orange in the North store it will be 62 cents. But how do we look that up in a table? For instance here we have a table of sales and we can see that the first sale is the West store and it's an apple. What's the price? It should be able to look up here to find out that the West store apple price is $1.09. So how can we do this using formulas? And we're going to look at how to do it using two functions, the match function and the index function. So we're going to learn how to use those in the process. So I've got three blank columns here. We're going to use that to experiment before we end up with our final formula. It's important to know how to do this because sometimes formulas can be so complex just building them all at once right out of your head is very difficult. So this is how you build complex formulas. We're going to use a blank cell right here. I'm going to hit the equals key and I'm going to look up match and just refresh my memory at what match looks like. Match takes three parameters. Search for, search where, and matching method. Matching method is important here because we're looking for an exact match. But search for and search where are what we want. So we're going to type match and the first parameter is going to be what we're searching for. So we'll click here on the name of the store in that row. And I'll hit comma. Now where's it going to search? Well, it's going to search this entire row here, this header row that has all the store names in it. So I'll just click here on the left side and you can see it selects the entire thing. And it says it's going to search in the prices table and it's going to basically look in the area here for it. And I'm going to close a parenthesis and hit return and I get a 3. And indeed I can find the West column is the third one. 1, 2, 3. Let's use match again to find the product in this column here. So I'll click on the column header there and now you can see it's going to correctly identify apple as being in the second row. First row, second row. Great. So now we need to learn about the index function. So we'll do index and we'll search for it here and we can see the parameters and basically it's going to take a range and then it wants the row and the column. So the range in this case is going to be this entire table. So we'll select this entire table here. Now it wants which row in this range. So the row is the vertical dimension there. So it's the second one. It's basically the product and then the column. And that should then match it up. And sure enough, there it is. It gives me $1.09. If I were to go and change now this to say, oh, this was supposed to be the center store, it will change to $1.04. And if I change it to it's supposed to be a banana, you can see it's 77. So it's always matching there. Now we don't want to have all these extra columns here. So we're going to want to do this in one formula. So taking the knowledge that we've learned from here, we can now go and say we want the index of this whole table and the first parameter here is going to be match of the product here. So it's going to be which row matches. So we want to match the product to column A and then match and then the store to the first header row there. And we've basically done the same thing but instead of three separate cells we have it in one cell. And now we get that there. And we can delete these and we can, if we want, collapse this table. And now I can copy and paste this where I want. So you can see East Peach matches, see there's Peach, there's East, 27 cents. Valley Banana matches Valley Banana, 43 cents. Now if we want to keep entering new data, fortunately what happens is formulas get repeated. So as I enter in a new one, you can see I get a little alert there because it's missing data. So I'll enter in, let's say this is going to be the airport store and it's going to be a orange. And you can see the amount automatically gets filled in correctly, airport orange, $1.10. So that's how we can do two-dimensional lookups using the index and match functions.